All right, now we're going to talk about dividing decimals. So before we talk about dividing decimals, let's just remember a couple of things. If you take 370 and 4/10 divided by 8, that gives you 46 3/10. So all these numbers have special names. If we're dividing two numbers, this number that we're dividing is called the dividend. The number we're dividing it by is called the divisor. And finally, the answer is called the quotient. And if I write it along division, the same is true. So this would be my divisor, the 8. 370 and 4/10 would be the dividend. And then my quotient would be 46 3/10. So keeping that in mind, you should know what each of these are when I refer to them. So we're going to live by one rule, and that is that the divisor has to always be a whole number. Okay, so keeping that in mind, let's say we want to do the division we did above. We want to divide 370.4 divided by 8. So in this example, my divisor is already a whole number, so I don't have to do anything special. I can just go ahead and divide. Let me show you the role the decimal point is going to play. In this case, it's not going to do anything other than move right up to the quotient. So my quotient is going to have a decimal place in the same spot, and that's the only role of the decimal point. So then I'm just going to divide the same way that I would any other two numbers. So I ask myself, how many times is 8 going to 37? And it goes in 4 times. 4 times 8 is 32. I have a remainder of 5. I bring down the 0. How many times is 8 going to 50? And it goes in 6 times. I get 48, remainder of 2. Bring down the 4. 8 goes into 24. A total of 3 times. Now notice I wrote this 3 behind the decimal point because the number I brought down, the 4, was also behind the decimal point. So 3 times 8 is 24, and I get a remainder of 0. So that means that 370 and 4/10 divided by 8 is 46 3/10. Now let's try an example that may not necessarily have a divisor that's a whole number. So let's try the following. Let's try 10 and 764 thousandths divided by 2 3/10. So when we have something like this, notice that our divisor is not a whole number. So what we're going to do is we're going to make it a whole number. And to make this a whole number, what we do is we move the decimal point to the right as many times as we need to, so it becomes a whole number. So what I need to do here is I need to move it to the right once. And I also need to move this one to the right once. And here's why. If you think of division using fractions as a fraction bar, the way to move the decimal point to the right is to multiply it by 10. And whatever I do to the denominator of the fraction, I have to do to the numerator of the fraction, so that when I multiply by 10 over 10, my answer is the same. So what I get out of this, out of multiplying by 10 over 10, is 107 64/100 divided by 23. And because I didn't multiply by anything except 1, whatever answer I get out of the left will be the same as whatever answer I get out of the right. And that's the beauty of math, is we can manipulate numbers this way in order to get the answers we need. Okay, so now that we have this, let's go ahead and multiply, or let's go ahead and divide the two numbers. So my new division is 107 64/100 divided by 23. And even though they're different numbers than what I started off with, my answer is going to be the same for the reasons I just explained down there. So let's go ahead and divide. So I asked myself, how many times is 23 going to 107? And it does so 4 times. 4 times 3 is 12, carry the 1. 4 times 2 is 8, and 1 is 9. And I get a remainder of 15. I can then bring down the 6. Remember, the rule of the decimal point was just to simply move up to the quotient. So that's what it's going to do. So how many times is 23 going to 156? And it does so a total of 6 times. 6 times 3 is 18, carry the 1. 6 times 2 is 12, and 1 is 13. And I get a remainder of 18. bring down the 4. How many times is 23 going to 184? And it does 8 times. 8 times 3 is 24. Carry the 2. 8 times 2 is 16. And 2 is 18. And I get a remainder of 0. So my answer is 4 and 68 hundredths. So there's a few more of these in the textbook. Sometimes what's going to end up happening is that you're going to get a non-ending decimal. In that case, you'd usually be asked to round to the nearest hundredth or the nearest thousands or so on. So when you have to do that, just go ahead and round to the number that it tells you. Let me give you an example of that, I guess. So let's say we want to divide 17 and 5 tenths by 48 hundredths. And we want to round to the nearest hundredths. Okay, so let's go ahead and do our math. Because our divisor is at a whole number, I need to move the decimal point to the right 2 times, which makes my division 17,500 divided by 48. Okay, so 48 goes into 175 a total of 3 times. I'm going to get a remainder of 31. Bring down the 0. 48 goes into 310, a total of 6 times, I'm sorry. When I move the decimal point to the right 2 times, I actually end up with 1,750, not 17,500. So when I multiply it times 6, I get 288. And when I subtract these two, I get 22. I can then bring down the next 0. Notice that this decimal point here, so my quotient is going to have a decimal point there as well. Okay, how many times is 48 going to 220? And it does 4 times and get 192. 220 minus 192, I'm going to do this over here. 220 minus 192 is 28. I can add another 0 and bring that down. How many times does 48 go into 280? And I can a total of 5 times. And 5 times 48 will give me 240. And get a remainder of 40. Bring down yet another 0. How many times is 48 going to 400? 384 times. Or sorry. It does so 8 times. 8 times 48 is 384. 400 minus 384 is 16. So don't be afraid if this takes you a little bit to figure out. I'm already looking at a worked out problem, so that's why I'm moving through it pretty quickly. But you should take the time to go ahead and do this. So what I end up with is I end up with my quotient over here. My quotient is 36.458. And I still have a remainder, so I could keep on going forever. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to round to the nearest hundredth. So here's my hundredth place. I am going to use my test digit, which is 8, so that means I'm going to round up. So when I round to the 100th place, I get 36.46. So this is my rounded answer right here. So notice one thing, if you're rounding to the 100th place, you need to find up to the thousands so that you can round.